integration of awakening and responsibility is the answer to the question, how can I give my life completely to great love? This question is just words, of course, and the meaning of those words depends on how we live. Nonetheless, there's a word that can be given as the answer. That is my vow, my purpose, my life purpose, to live that, to manifest that. That can be done once we've let go. So we've truly let go and stopped obstructing it, and thereby stopped obstructing the whole world. It's important that we set forth the determination at the beginning of the path of great compassion, great care. It's essential that we clarify that with determination in the beginning. Having done that, having clarified that in the beginning, then we're in a position to continue it throughout. The way we continue it throughout is that when we get distracted, anytime we get distracted, of course there may be periods when we don't get distracted, but at some point, it's very likely that we will get distracted. At that time of distraction, one response is, rather than bring our attention directly back, we take a bit more of a circuitous route through the landscape of compassion. And that means that we start with encouraging words to ourselves. Caring, loving, compassionate words towards ourselves. Having done that, having given ourselves that support, we expand that to the whole world. A dedication to all living beings to practice for their liberation, for their maturation, for their happiness. And then, with that connection, we have an enormous power that can be brought back into concentration. And we concentrate from there. Concentrate for as long as we can. But if distraction emerges, then we once again start with encouraging words for ourselves, feel that sense of compassion, spread that to all living things, and from that place, return to the technique. So for now, take a moment to give yourself encouraging words, feel that, and spread that to all beings. Having done that, bring your attention with the power of that compassion to a focus space. If you're not sure what focus space to use, then simply use your breath. But if you already have an established focus space, you can use that. If you're not sure, simply bring your attention to your breath. Remember, you bring your attention to your breath for the benefit of all beings. I was listening to a different teacher teach recently. She said, if you're having trouble doing this for yourself, if you don't have the strength to continue to concentrate in this way for yourself, then do it for all beings. Do it for all living things. And you'll find a new kind of strength when you have that determination. At some point, you may get distracted, and for the sake of this exercise, you may find it helpful to put a very strict standard on distraction. Because at this point, we're making use of distraction in order to cultivate compassion. And so, your very high standard can be something like, if you're aware of anything other than your breath in any way at all. Which is to say, if you can hear my voice right now, you're distracted. In that case, very good. You just got distracted. In that case, you can once again encourage yourself. Encourage yourself. Treat yourself with compassion. Feel that. And then spread that. Spread that to all living things, and with the strength of that connection, that compassion, return once again to the focus space until you're distracted again. Continue with this technique, continue with this cycle. Alternating between a cultivation technique, which is nurture positive or arousing compassion for yourself and others, and an observation technique, attending to, for example, your breath.